is the Wizard Magic Review Blackpool Special.
Wow.
I'm Dave.
I'm Paul.
And let's get straight to it. Are you looking forward to Blackpool, Paul?
Who's not looking forward to Blackpool?
Come on. We are leaving today for Blackpool to set up the stand tomorrow and get it all sorted, ready for opening on Friday. Five new releases on the Wizard, the World Magic Shop stand. Wizard Magic Review presenters will be there. And with that, I must mention Wayne Fox, who's so sorry that he can't be here today. He really wanted to be on the show. Wayne has new releases at Blackpool as well. I'm sure you'll see those on Wayne's social media. But come and see us on the stand as well. But let's talk about these five releases.
But before we talk about them, I'm not paid by Dave. I'm not paid by Wayne.
I did buy you breakfast.
Well, he bought me breakfast. Right. He did buy. Yes,
that's
take
paid.
A
that's
but my opinion here isn't. I just want to make it clear that my opinion here isn't because I'm sitting next
Say
to him.
Everything's
and,
brilliant.
Everything's brilliant.
Yeah.
But it's not, okay? I'm going to be honest with everything
it's
I say.
It's not a review. It can't be a review, because we are biased.
No, but I'm still going to be
honest. You've seen the development of these projects.
It's true, I have.
So, first of all, I'm going to mention one that's actually been out before 8 years ago, but it is a new version of it. It's Mystery Solved 2.0. And this has been made and remanufactured by the TCC team, and it is the perfect size for a folded card.
Yeah.
Because when Mystery Solved, the first one, came out, I created it for what I still use it for to this day, which is a lottery ticket production. And I only ever wanted to use it for a kind of larger billet. People like Dan White have used it on TV for exactly that purpose as well. But a lot of people did want to use it with a folded card. In fact, I saw a video on social media last week, Kancho Jim performing it,
oh, wow,
with a folded card, even though it was the larger box. And a lot of people messaged me and said, oh, you know, it's a shame it's not the same size as a Mercury card, folded card. And now it has been designed specifically for purpose. It is also different in design, so it's not chamfered. It's a lot straighter. It's a thicker box. It looks more sort of crystal, actually.
It does look classier
than it did before.
Yeah.
Being that it's smaller means that it fits under a glass as well. So if you want to isolate it on the table, you can put it under something like a glass or a cup. So there's lots more advantages. I still use it exactly as I've always used it, with the lottery ticket. But the fact that you can cover it up and it's there from the start makes it a lot easier to use. And I do now prefer the smaller box than the much larger box. But it is a new version of Mystery Solved 2.0. If you see it on the stand, the retention of vision is incredible. When you tip it out,
I think it's one of the best.
You can use it as a mystery card plot, and the card's always in full view. I had this idea a while ago where you kind of show a spectator that you've got a card that says your name, and it just says your name, the words. You fold that up, and the advantage with Mystery Solved, you can put it into the box as well. You put it in the box, and then you leave it there, and then you finish a card routine for a spectator, and you say, wouldn't it be cool if that card in there had your name on it? Everybody would go crazy, right? And everybody in the audience is thinking, well, of course,
not really.
It's a joke. But then you actually tip it out, and it kind of fools the audience, kind of like a McCumical prediction style thing, at the same time as fooling the spectator. So that was kind of like a plot that I had. I posted that video, the original Mystery Solved, years ago. But that's a really cool routine that you can do with it. That's Mystery Solved 2.0, which is out at Blackpool 2023.
Very cool.
And next I'm going to mention the Inversion holder. So this is something that I've used for about 6 years, but I had a very primitive version of it. And on the tutorial, if you buy the Inversion holder, you'll see the original version before it went to the manufacturers to get produced. And it is a way to conceal fruit or final loads for cups and balls.
Can I just say, I'm more excited about this than you think I might be.
Okay.
Because, so I don't know if anyone's noticed, but I'm plumper than some magician. So if I'm carrying, you know, if I'm carrying final loads in my pockets, you can see them, right? Yeah. So I tend to shy away from that sort of end result, not for any other reason than just, you know, I'm bulging anyway. Let's face that. this solves that problem really well for me. Yeah. So, Jenny, I haven't told you this before, but I'm quite excited for that.
And a lot of people, do sort of maybe thinking right now, well, you know, there's been things that clips on belts,
yeah,
that kind of thing before, but it's, the problem with that for me is it's a little bit lower. And if you move or tip or lean forward, then the jacket tends to ride up, certainly the jackets I wear, and can reveal those loads. So the fact that this is an inversion holder, it's inverted, and it holds it in the position that it does, and you'll see a mannequin displaying it on the Wizard Magic Review World Magic Shop stand, you'll see it in position, and I'll obviously demonstrate it. I'll put some clips on the screen now, because one of the main advantages of the inversion holder is the fact that you don't need to go in your pockets.
Yeah.
It is just a very sort of natural motion, and you can have two side by side, and it's completely invisible when worn, unlike, like Paul said, when you've got it in your pockets, you can see those bulges. A lot of my suits are slim fitting, single breasted, and you can actually see if you've got something too bulky in your pockets.
The other thing I was going to mention, which you just said, is it's a really natural motion to get it out. It's hidden.
Nobody can see it, and it resets, and it's fixed in there really well. And only the way naturally you would remove it from the holder allows it to come out of the holder.
Right.
Does that make sense?
Yeah, it does. Yeah.
Right. So now let's talk about,
what are we doing next?
Overlaid. Overlaid is my app that's been brought out by Magie Factory, which is the same producers as R-Digit. So when I first started to think about, shall I finally bring this idea out? I've had this idea for a long time, but the technology's actually only been possible very, very recently. I know you know what I'm talking about because you're in the app world, but I am so excited about this app. You can do so much with Overlaid. You say something first about it.
I don't know what to say. I know David's been performing a similar effect for years, and then suddenly it's exploded.
So Overlaid allows you to overlay and animate digital effects within images.
Yes.
That are captured in real time. So that could be on your phone, it could even be on the spectator's phone. These can be selfies if you want to. And when you've done the effect, it also freezes the moment of magic forever.
Yes.
Overlaid allows you to enhance existing effects, like double cross. So I've got my digital double cross, for example. With digital double cross, you can take a picture of the spectator holding their hand, just like this, and then you put your phone down, and then you draw a cross in your hand, so you still need to use the Magic Smith double cross.
Mm-hmm.
You remove the cross from their hand, drop it into the picture. It's now in the picture that they took before, where they didn't have anything on their hand. Then, in a sort of magical gesture, you can remove it from the picture and place it into their hands.
Right, and then they open their hands.
And the cross is in their hand, because that's just a normal double cross finale. But what you've got is this digital, like, bouncing back and forth before it actually goes into their hand. And the great thing is, as well, they get to have the souvenir of the picture with or without the cross, however you want to perform it, because everything is customizable in the back end to create these overlaid images.
And in case you missed it, because he went past it quite quickly, that can be on the spectator's phone.
Yes, it can be on the spectator's phone.
So you can borrow the spectator's phone and take the photo with the spectator's phone. That can be done with this app.
And
but it's not only crosses, is it, Dave?
No, it's anything. Anything you take a picture of, it's iPhone only, unfortunately, but anything you take a picture of, you can convert to a PNG file and use it in the app. So we've been messing around with card in window.
Yeah.
We've been messing around with taking a selfie with you and your spectator and the card kind of floating in the picture, which is absolutely amazing. So you could take a picture of a kid like this at a birthday party, and then the card would be in between their hands, or get all the kids to hold their hands up.
You could ask them there, you could get them to pick a celebrity.
Yeah.
And that celebrity appears in the background of that photo.
Yeah.
You could It could work with sponge ball routines, but magically put in sponge balls.
Anything can be added into an image. Anything. Rainbow card, for example, a great effect that uses a gimmick card. You can do that with the app.
Without the gimmick.
Without the gimmick, and change gimmicks daily if you wanted to. And not only make the thing appear, you can actually make it change as well. So you can make one card appear in the wallet, for example, or photo frame, or however you want to do it, and then pass your hand over the top, and then in the image it would morph and change, and then they keep that image.
And that can be a... So the possibility... That could be a dual reality type routine, right?
Yeah.
That could be... And the point is they keep it. So you could, for instance, do a rainbow card with your business card.
Yeah. Or make something appear on the back of your business card. So they hold something like this.
Yeah.
Like a blank business card. They put it down and they don't realise there's something written on the other side. And there isn't anything written on the other side, but then their drawing or whatever appears.
Photo, yeah.
But they've chosen with digital force bag or off cards or anything. But you get to overlay and animate images digitally into photographs that you've just captured in real time. And these enhance other routines. It comes with preloaded routines, but just like our Digit, it's going to have its own Facebook community. The guys that are developing it, they're just as excited as I am. They're already coming back to me with ideas about... one of the guys is already working on an idea with French Kiss and seeing the card change in the picture before they change in real life.
Wow.
It's great. We'll have demonstrations on the stand. I'm hoping to have just a demonstrator on the Wizard Magic Review World Magic Shop stand on the balcony between 12 and 3 o'clock every single day, demonstrating overlaid. So that's the new app that's out.
And the potential is just amazing.
Yeah. I'll be in the Ruskin, the Knights of Blackpool, demming the digital double cross and the card apparition effect, because they're my personal favourites. But I know so many people are going to come up with other ones. This has been very popular already. A couple of people are out there sort of testing this and using it. Michael J. Fitch, this is his new favourite effect.
Oh, okay.
This is my magnetic eight ball. So, magnetic eight ball. So, I've always loved the eight ball production.
Yeah, I've seen
the John Bannon effect. I've had different versions on Topic DVDs. And my original lecture DVD that came out to the Magic community had a production of a black eight from a deck of cards and then a Topic vanish afterwards, I think. But I've always loved the eight ball. I've never been a fan of the sort of eight ball holders that are out there that you have to sort of push your thumb into, and there's always that extra force, and it's always seems to telegraph it a little bit more, and the elbows need to go up. And also other holders that hold things with sort of wire downwards, and you pin it onto your jacket and they can rip the lining of your suit. So I created, along with the TCC team, something that I've had for 10 years, right? And I'm not just saying that. If you buy this, because I know a lot of magicians, when they bring out products, they go, I've been doing this 10 years. And I'm the same. I look at it and go, show me the evidence. Well, yeah. on the tutorial, you'll see the YouTube video that I put up 10 years ago at World Magic Shop. I look completely different. I'm not wearing glasses, and I'm actually showing the eight ball and talking about, this is an idea, I've been using it, and we might bring it out one day. That was 10 years ago. But now the TCC team have brought this to reality. That is the magnetic eight ball. It's made from a real eight ball. So when you drop it on the table out of a pen cap or however you want to use it, I love the solid and stretch, because with the solid and stretch effect, you take the pen cap off or the spectator's signing a card, then they discover that the pen cap is solid, and then you drop it out of the pen cap that's solid, implying there's something in there, and then you say, how did that fit in there? And then you stretch the pen cap. I'll be demming that on the World Magic Shop stand. But this is the magnetic eight ball. The main advantage with it is the steel is so smooth. You don't need to push it. It just literally glides out from its hiding place. You just literally roll your hand on your jacket. And it comes with a magnet, which is encased in leather. and whether you have it under a waistcoat like I do all the time or in the inside of your jacket, it's perfect for holding out an eight ball. That is the magnetic eight ball.
Yeah, there's nothing to see there, is there?
There is nothing to see. If you really knew what you were looking for, you might go, oh, I think I can see something. But nobody does. There might be a slight discoloration. But that is the gimmick side there. And you can't see anything, but that is the gimmick side where the magnet attaches. I'll be demonstrating all these products on the World Magic Shop stand. And like I said, the app demonstrations will only be 12 till 3. I think Henry White's going to be doing those as well.
Oh, bless him.
I've tried good to man. Rope him in and get that sorted. Now, finally, here we go. It is the follow-up to the 52-1 deck. How does that get any better? Well, the odds have increased. It is the Accumulator deck. It's called the Accumulator deck because, as I say on the trailer, the odds have increased.
Yeah. And it's no longer 52-1, it's impossible.
Yeah, it was always impossible. When Wayne came up with the original, it was mind-blowing. Then I came up with the deck, the gimmick deck. This is another completely different gimmick deck. It's the same cards as 52-1, which is useful because if you've performed 52-1 all these years, you don't need to learn any different cards.
Right.
But the difference with the routine is you can do the normal 52-1 effect, so you lose nothing, but what do you gain? As a topper, you can perform card at any number with a freely thought of card. In the same way that you think of a card in the 52-1 deck and the spectator is convinced that they're thinking of a card from a deck of 52, it's exactly the same. They name any number, and the card is at the number when you count down.
To make it even clearer. An audience member, so those cards are, you spread some cards, everyone is different.
They're all different.
They're all different, okay? Someone comes up, they look at that spread of cards and they think of one of those cards. They never write it down. They never tell anyone. They think of that card. Someone else names a number. You deal to that number.
And the card's at that number.
Clearly take that card out. That's their card. What card were you thinking? You turn it over, it's their card.
That's exactly fair. It's the follow-up to the 52. I prefer to perform it as a follow-up to 52-1.
Yeah.
So I like to get one spectator to name look at a red card, one looks at a black card. When you spread the cards, and then the first person's card, you cut to it, or they can cut to it, just like 52-1. And then you say, you know, maybe we got lucky. Let's try something else. You named a number. What was the number you named? And then you count down, and the card is at that number. The guy on the every time I've done it, it gets amazing reactions. The guy on the trailer, it was at a wedding, and he literally followed me around all day. Ran away, going, no,
yeah,
no.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, no way, get the hell out of my house. It was like Harrison Ford on the Blaine special. It was incredible. He was just going, no, no, that can't be done. And and when the camera had finished rolling, it didn't stop there. He was on me all day going, how can you do that? I was just thinking of it. She named a number, and it was there. That can't be done. You didn't do anything. I watched you counting.
So card at any number is called the Holy Grail for a reason, right? Yeah. Because it is ridiculously impossible. But
Created by David Burglass.
I should have credited.
I was talking to the other night, and you know, he did create the Holy Grail. It's like, if you can do that, that's unbelievable. But normally you say, name a card, name a number.
Yeah, now you're saying, think of a card.
So yeah, think of one, and they think they're thinking of any card. So I might be biased, but I think that in a spectator's mind is a little bit stronger, because you've not even told them a card.
Yeah.
They're just thinking of it.
It's a miracle. This is a miracle. And as David said, you can perform the 52-1. So you can perform all of the effects that come with 52-1 with this. So this can be the tossed out effect.
Stand up tossed out deck you can do.
So all of the things that came with 52-1 plus thought of card at any number.
Yeah.
I mean, it doesn't.
And I'll be demming it on the stand. You'll see how it plays. You'll see how it's done. It's not a pipe dream. You will see me do it. Come and see it on the stand. Come and watch it like a layman, and you'll see how it react. Yeah. How you'll react to it. There's a lot of products there. Blackpool is going to be very exciting. Wayne has some releases as well.
It's a shame he couldn't be here.
Yeah, he's got his a brand new version. It is incredible. I wish he was here to talk to about it, but I'm sure Wayne will be doing videos on his own social media, so check that out. He's got a Crazy Man's Handcuffs effect.
Which it's superb.
Yeah, with a gimmick, with a gimmicked Crazy Man's Handcuffs.
But a worth it gimmick, right?
That looks like the bands just melt through each other. He's got... We came down to see him performing it at the show at the Magic Circle. His I Know London.
Yeah.
He got a standing ovation for that set. So that was his painting with all the reveals in it. I'm sure he'll talk you through that. He's kind of combined his two passions, magic and art, together. That is going to be out. And then he's got a new twist on the light heavy. But I'll let you tell. Go and see Wayne. Come and see him. We're all on the same stand. We're all going to be there on the World Magic Shop Wizard Magic Review stand at Blackpool 2023. I can't wait.
Yeah, I'm not surprised.
What are you most looking forward to at the convention?
Saturday night.
The competition.
The competition. Yeah.
That's mine too.
Yeah.
I am intrigued by that, the lecturer that's coming to talk about getting more gigs and that kind of thing. There's a lot of chatter about him on Facebook.
I haven't seen that. I'll look that up.
Yeah. I think he's a controversial character, but I think he might just turn up and people might just go, well, hang on, he is doing it. He does know his stuff, but he's one of those things, he sort of motivates people, but kind of butts heads at the same time on social media. Part of the reason I hardly go on Facebook these days. But that's going to be a highlight, I think, for all the right or all the wrong reasons, but I'm really looking forward to the competition on the Saturday night. I think that's going to be the highlight of the whole weekend.
Well, I'm there for the Saturday night and there for the Sunday only.
Right.
So Saturday night, Sunday. But I'm not going to be on the stand, but if you see me around, come and say hello.
You are going to be on the stand.
Well, I'm going to...
Didn't I tell you?
No, you did not. I need to go.
I need a break.
But do come and say hello. It'd be lovely to chat.
Thank you so much for watching the Wizard Magic Review Blackpool special. We are going to get in the car, we're going to get loaded, and we are going to set off to Blackpool. Until then, I'm Dave.
I'm Paul.
We'll see you next time at Blackpool.
Yeah!